Emily and the relief driver. An engine's crew is a crucial part of their work. They allow the engines to operate and ensure their health during jobs. They also provide companionship to engines on long journeys. And they perform certain tasks that engines can't. In the modern age, cell phones and other modern devices are a great asset. They allow the engine's crew to communicate with other crew members, stations, and signal operators at lightning-fast speeds. One morning, the engines of Vickerstown sheds left to begin their jobs. But Emily's driver and fireman still hadn't arrived. She was late to pick up her first train, and Rebecca ended up having to cover for her. Soon, the shedmaster approached with Emily's fireman and a young relief driver. "Sorry about the wait. The driver called in sick about an hour ago, and we had to scramble to find one who was available on such short notice." "That's all right, sir. I'm ready whenever they are."
"Then let's get to it."
Emily picked up her second train of the day right on time, a stopping service to Wellsworth from Vickerstown. However, it became clear early on that Emily's relief driver was inexperienced. He frequently pulled out his phone or leaned against the cab to rest. His distracted nature caused problems all along the journey and throughout the rest of the day. Emily and her fireman had to constantly remind him of basic things.
"Hey, we're going way too slow. Express is due through in 10 minutes and we need to get off this line."
"Yeah, whatever."
But no matter how many times they reminded him, he just kept getting distracted. I mean, seriously, what's he getting paid for at this point? His job's to be my driver, and he's doing a sloppy job at that. So many people nowadays don't care about anyone but themselves. Exactly. If he keeps this up, he's gonna cause a roadie accident. Hopefully not. Although, sometimes people need a rude awakening. Let's just cross our buffers that no one gets hurt. Emily had to take a passenger train from Knapford to Croven's Gate. It was a guaranteed connection, so there wouldn't be any room for dawdling. Emily's fireman made that clear to her relief driver.
"Now listen here, this train needs to get to Croven's Gate by 3. I'm expecting no nonsense from you. Put your phone away and keep your eyes on the track."
Yeah, whatever.
The journey started off well. Emily's relief driver stayed attentive and stopped when he needed to. Spencer had arrived at Croven's Gate, bringing the Duke and Duchess of Boxford to a meeting. He was waiting to proceed to the yard, but the entrance was blocked, so he had to wait. The signal just outside of Croven's Gate went red. But Emily's driver was going so fast, the signal hadn't changed by the time they'd passed.
"Oi, put your phone down and pay attention to the line, you git."
Stop.
But it was too late.
"And what exactly do you think you're playing at?"
"You idiot, what did I tell you about keeping your eyes on the line?"
"Well, I was just being a fool."
Everyone knew that voice. Stepping out of the station was the Duke and Duchess, alongside Mr. Percival and the Fat Controller.
"Nathan, just what do you have to say for yourself?"
"One of my mates called me. I couldn't just leave him ringing."
"Och, you damn well could have.
When the choice is between chatting with your friends and doing your job, which do you think is more bloody important? Emily's guard exited the rear coach and strolled over to the others. Luckily, everyone's fine. Just a little bounced about and cross is all. The fat controller sighed.
Uncouple the coaches. We'll refund their tickets for the trouble.
Then he turned to Spencer. Spencer, please take your coach to the works. And bring Emily if it's not too much trouble.
I'd be happy to, sir. As long as it's all right with the Duke and Duchess.
You might as well. We won't be going anywhere for a while.
As for you, neighbor, I shall talk to you later.
Emily was repaired quickly, and her driver was back at work waiting for her. As for Nathan, the relief driver, he was promptly fired from the railway. He found work elsewhere, but now he's much more attentive to his job.